Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Today is our fourth lecture. But before starting my lecture, I want to clear one thing that the Pakistani studies is incomplete without the map. So you people must do the practice of map making on rough pages because it is very important for Pakistan studies. Let's start the topic. Today our topic is related from book page number 3 or book page number 4, which is from chapter number 1, The Foundation and Components of Ideology of Pakistan. First, I want to show the map. It's a map of South Asia. Look at this: Pakistan, India, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Maldives, and Afghanistan. These 8 countries, also known as SAARC countries. But before the partition, it was known as these 2 states, mostly known as British India, the map of British India. And we are talking about the Muslims of British India before the partition. Look at the topic. The foundation and components. There are 6 foundation and components: religion Islam and belief on Tawheed, Islamic code of life, Islamic concept of sovereignty, social justice and equality, Islamic democracy, and equal rights of minorities. But we will talk about only 4. And for your convenience, I selected the main points on separate sheet. Look at this. Foundation and components. Foundation means asas or bunyad. Pakistan ki ideology mein kon kon se aisi bunyad thi ya aise ajza the ke jinhone Pakistan banane mein ahem kirdar ada kiya. Number 1 is religion Islam and belief in Tawheed. A separate nationhood of the Muslims is Kalma-e-Tawheed, which is contrary to the Western ideology. Islam, Muslim nationalism is not based on territory or caste or creed or wealth. The new nation laid down when the first Indian embraced Islam. यानी उसी वक्त एक नई कौम वजूद में आ गई थी कि जब इस सब कॉन्टिनेंट में या ब्रिटिश इंडिया में पहले एक किसी इंडियन ने इस्लाम कबूल किया एज अ मज़हब. क्लियर? हमारा बिलीव, आवर टोटल बिलीव इज़ ऑन कलमा तौहीद. द मुस्लिम लाइफ इज़ रिवॉल्व अराउंड द इस्लाम. इस्लाम इज़ द न्यूक्लियस एंड द होल लाइफ ऑफ द मुस्लिम रिवॉल्व अराउंड द Islam. The next topic is Islamic code of life. Islam is not only a religion but complete code of life. Mukammal zabta hayat. Ye ek mazhab nahi hai. It is not just a religion. It is also a guideline for the best life system. It gives us the solution of the social, political or economic needs. There were 2 aims behind the creation of Pakistan: for the solution of political, economic or social crisis, and another aim was to establishing such an enlightened or moderate society where the Muslims spend their lives according to the teachings of Islam. Islamic concept of sovereignty, iqtidar-e-ala, supreme authority, ikhtiyar. As a Muslim, we believe that the whole power belongs to Almighty Allah. And in Islam, the basic objective of human life except sovereignty of Allah Almighty, abide by His Nabi. Means, as a Muslim, we follow the teachings of Nabi. Hazur Sallam ke bataye hue tareekon par amal kare. Or, as a Muslim, we must believe that the whole power belongs to Allah. And the position of the human being is vicegerent or Khalifa of Allah in the Islamic point of view. And we also believe that We are the assistants of Allah, and we follow and we do the duties in the prescribed limits of Allah. The next is social justice and equality. Justice, insaf, equality, musawat. No discrimination can be made on the basis of caste, creed, color, or race in the Islamic society. The only thing that distinguishes one person from other is taqwa, the fear of Allah Almighty. Matlab, we are not different, or we are, our Islamic society is not based on caste system, creed, color, or material wealth or race, we can say. The Islamic society is based on equality. And the only thing which make us different or unique from other is taqwa, the fear of Allah Almighty. Before the establishment of Pakistan, the Muslims of South Asia were the victim or nishana bane hue the. The total injustice, inequality, and they're deprived of their rights. One of the important of aim of the establishment of Pakistan was to establish such a social order in which everyone or every segment enjoy equal rights. Even the equal rights of minorities also guaranteed in the constitution of Pakistan. So these four objective components are the base of Pakistan ideology. The next two components we will discuss in the next lecture. For more clearance, you must read the topic from book page 3 or 4. There is the Quranic saying, O human, surely we have created you of a male and a female, that you may know, that made and made you tribes and families, that you may know each other. Surely the most honorable of you with Allah is the most careful of his duty. Yani, ay mu'min, humne tumhe ek mard aur ek aurat se banaya aur tumhe tumhari familyon aur kabilon mein dal diya aur tum taake tum ek dusre ko achhi tarah jaan sako, lekin Allah ki nazar mein wo behtareen hai jo ke bahut muttaqi aur parhezgar hai. Clear? The sayings of social justice and equality related to this topic, the saying of Holy Quran, is very important. Must read it carefully. For more clearance, read it page number 3 and 4. Inshallah, in next lecture we must talk about Islamic democracy and equal rights of minorities. Thank you.